Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to all students of AWM Chennai in online session. Hope you are well. May Allah bless you. I am Dr. Selima Sultana, Associate Professor of Pharmacology and Therapeutics. Today, my topic is steroid, that is glucocorticoid. This topic is important not for only your examination but also for your professional life thereafter. Steroid or glucocorticoid is an adrenocortical hormone. All adrenocortical hormones have a common steroid nucleus named cyclopentanopyrhydropenanthrin nucleus, and they are released from three zones of adrenal cortex. Glucocorticoid is released from zona fasciculata of adrenal cortex. Now, the synthesis of glucocorticoid. Glucocorticoid synthesized from cholesterol, which is the precursor of glucocorticoid. Then, from cholesterol, pregnenolone is synthesized. From pregnenolone, progesterone is synthesized. From progesterone, 11-deoxycorticosterone is synthesized. And ultimately, corticosterone is synthesized. From progesterone, also 17-hydroxyprogesterone is synthesized. From 17-hydroxyprogesterone, 11-deoxycortisol is synthesized. And then ultimately, cortisol is synthesized. Now, the classification of glucocorticoid. Glucocorticoid can be classified into natural and synthetic. Natural, there is cortisol or hydrocortisone. Synthetic, according to duration of action, it may be short-acting, intermediate-acting, or long-acting. Short-acting glucocorticoids are prednisolone, methylprednisolone, and prednisone. And intermediate-acting, it may be fluprednisolone, paramethasone, triamcinolone. Long-acting, dexamethasone, betamethasone, or dexlemethasone. And classification according to route of administration are oral, prednisolone, inhalation, fluticasone, budesonide, dexlemethasone, parenteral, hydrocortisone, betamethasone, dexamethasone, etc. Now, the daily secretion of cortisol is 10 to 20 mg per day. Plasma half-life is 60 to 90 minutes. Peak secretion in the morning and lowest secretion deep sleep at night and at the evening. Because in the morning, steroid secretion is at the peak level and morning's dose has little or no effect on the hypothalamo-pituitary axis. In the evening and at the bedtime, adrenocorticotropic hormone secretion remains suppressed. Now, the mechanism of action of glucocorticoid or steroid. Glucocorticoid enters into the cell cytoplasm. As it is very lipid soluble, then it binds in the specific protein in the cytoplasm and forms steroid receptor complex. And this complex enters into the nucleus, binds with the glucocorticoid receptor element of a specific gene, and transcription reaction occurs. There is messenger RNA in the cytoplasm and then synthesis of new protein. This new protein is responsible for various effects of steroid. Now, the anti-inflammatory action of glucocorticoid. The phospholipid in the cell membrane produce phosphoarachidonic acid. Here, the enzyme is phospholipase A2. From arachidonic acid, there are two pathways, that is lipooxygenase pathway and cyclooxygenase pathway. From lipooxygenase pathway, leukotrienes are formed. From cyclooxygenase pathway, prostaglandin, leukotrienes, prostacycline are formed, and these are the inflammatory mediators. Now, steroid inhibits phospholipase A2 enzyme. So, ultimately, these inflammatory mediators cannot be produced. Effects of glucocorticoids. There are physiological effects and pharmacological effects. Physiological effects are on carbohydrate metabolism. It increases blood glucose level by stimulating gluconeogenesis and increasing glycogenolysis, and decreases peripheral utilization of glucose due to insulin antagonism and inhibits glucose uptake in the cell. On protein metabolism, it causes protein catabolism, that is breakdown of protein into amino acid. So there is negative nitrogen balance which causes muscle bursting skin becomes thin due to removal of skin protein from dermis, and increased capillary permeability causes bruising and stir in the skin and plethoric face. And bones causes reduction of bone protein matrix, leading to osteoporosis, and inhibits the number and function of osteoblast and synthesis of collagen. Growth slows in children. On fat metabolism, lipolysis and mobilizes fat from peripheral to upper part of the trunk and face, resulting in moon face, buffalo hump and pendulous abdomen. Effect on electrolytes, distal convoluted tubule, it increases reabsorption of sodium and water and causes increased blood pressure by increasing blood volume. Now the pharmacological effects of glucocorticoids, which are very important. Anti-inflammatory effects. Inhibits phospholipid A2 enzyme. It inhibits the synthesis of inflammatory mediators. It stabilizes the lysosomal membrane. No release of enzymes responsible for inflammatory response. Decrease the capillary permeability. Leukocyte cannot migrate to the area of inflammation and limits the ability of macrophages to phagocytose and kill microorganisms. Inhibit the release of interleukin-1 from macrophage and interleukin-2 from T lymphocytes. Reduction in circulating lymphocytes, monocytes, eosinophils and basophils due to their movement from the vascular bed to lymphoid tissue. Now the immunosuppressive effect of glucocorticoids, antibody production is reduced by large doses of steroid. Reduction in circulating lymphocytes, monocytes, eosinophils and basophils to their movement from the vascular bed to lymphoid tissue. Now decreases cell mediated immunity and limit the ability of macrophages to phagocytose and kill microorganisms. Inhibit the release of interleukin-1 from macrophages and interleukin-2 from T lymphocytes. Effects on complement activities are inhibited. It causes hypertension by increasing sodium and water retention and increasing vascular response to noradrenaline. It causes diabetes mellitus due to increases gluconeogenesis and glucose uptake, and increases sodium retention and potassium excretion, causes hypokalemia and decreased insulin secretion. Hyperacidity. Glucocorticoids inhibit prostaglandin synthesis. As a result, there is increased hydrochloric secretion, increased pepsin secretion and decreased mucus secretion. May lead to peptic ulcer disease because prostaglandin is a cytoprotective agent. Possibly suppress the local immune response against Helicobacter pylori. It also causes osteoporosis due to catabolism of protein matrix of bone, decreased absorption of calcium ion from gut due to anti-vitamin D activity, increases excretion of calcium ion leading to hypocalcemia. It also causes hypercoagulability due to increased number of RBC and platelets in circulation. And also it causes renal stone due to increased water retention and increased calcium excretion. And due to electrolyte imbalance, it causes insomnia, euphoria, depression. And it also causes growth retardation in children. What are the role of steroid in bronchial asthma? Roles are anti-inflammatory, immunosuppressive, allergic, and permissive role. Permissive role is in presence of a steroid, bronchodilation of adrenaline increases. Role of steroid in nephrotic syndrome, anti-inflammatory effect and immunosuppressive effect. What are the indications of glucocorticoid? Glucocorticoid is indicated almost all types of disease except where there is no contraindications. From A to S, there are lots of indications, like from as allergic reaction, asthma, allergic rhinitis, etc., the bones and joint disease, arthritis, bursitis, the colon and vascular disease, SLE, rheumatoid arthritis, the dermatological disease, atopic dermatitis, contact dermatitis, the eye disease, allergic conjunctivitis, for acute lung maturation, the GIT disorder, Crohn's disease, ulcerative colitis. And from age to age, there are so many indications. What are the contraindications of steroid? The absolute contraindications of is Cushing's syndrome. And there are many signs symptoms of Cushing syndrome, and features are moon face, buffalo hump, and pendulous abdomen, and there are lots of other features. And it also contraindicated in peptic ulcer disease, hypertension, diabetes mellitus, osteoporosis, infection, glaucoma, psychosis, tuberculosis, epilepsy, etc. And now the adverse effects of steroid. Adverse effects of Cushing syndrome, characterized by moon face, buffalo hump, pendulous abdomen, hirsutism, etc., diabetes mellitus, hypertension, glaucoma, growth retardation in children, increased intracranial pressure. Now the doses schedule. In acute case, large dose should be given in alternate days, can be given parenterally in acute case. In chronic case, started from small dose, gradually increase the dose and then gradually taper the dose, and should not withdraw suddenly. Dose should not withdraw suddenly, gradual tapering of the dose, because when steroid administered from outside, there is suppression of hypothalamic pituitary axis, that is no adrenocorticotropic hormone releasing hormone and no ACTH from pituitary gland, no release of steroid from adrenal gland. So sudden withdrawal of steroid leads to acute crisis of the hormone in the body. Effect of sudden withdrawal of fever, malaise, myalgia, arthralgia, increased intracranial intraocular pressure. Guidelines before prescribing cortisol to a patient. General principles to prescribe steroid therapy are appropriate diagnosis, grading of severity of disease, appropriate or suitable dose of the drug should be selected. It may be bolus or small. The host factor consideration are age, infection, diabetes mellitus, peptic ulcer disease, cardiac disease, osteoporosis, etc. Then monitoring of the patient, blood pressure should be monitored, blood glucose, body weight, x-ray, etc. The patient should maintain a steroid card, gradual tapering of the dose of steroid, and advice to the patient, glucocorticoid should be taken at single morning dose, because in the morning steroid secretion is at the peak level and morning dose has little or no effect on the hypothalamic pituitary axis. In the evening and at bedtime, ACTH secretion remains suppressed. In a stressful condition, it may double dose. Advice to the patient getting steroid. Glucocorticoid should be taken as a single morning dose. In stressful condition, double dose may be given. Always carry a steroid card and gradual tapering of the dose. Steroid in tuberculosis. Steroid should not be used in tuberculosis due to chance of immunosuppression. But steroid is used in some cases of miliary tuberculosis, fulminating type of tuberculosis, tuberculosis of a hollow tube cavity except gut, tuberculosis in pericardial or pleural cavity. Steroid is used in fulminating tuberculosis because steroid is a life-saving drug. It reduces toxemia. It will expose the germ so that antitubercular drugs can act on them. Steroid is used in hollow tube tuberculosis because hollow tube, such as bronchus, trachea, fallopian tube, uterus, etc., fibrosis, stricture, adhesion occur. Steroid is used to reduce adhesion and fibrosis. Steroid should not be given in gut tuberculosis. Doses schedule of steroid or glucocorticoid. In chronic case, started from small dose, then increase the dose, then gradual tapering of the dose. When steroid is administered from outside the body, there is suppression of hypothalamic pituitary axis, that is no adrenocorticotropic releasing hormone, from hypothalamus and no adrenocorticotropin hormone from pituitary gland. So there is resulting release of steroid from adrenal gland. So sudden withdrawal of the drug causes acute crisis of the hormone of the body, causes fever, malaise, hemorrhagia, arthralgia, etc. Today is the end of my discussion. And the next day I will discuss another topic.